Osiyo, it's how we say hello in Cherokee. In this episode, we'll explore the desert with a group of native students who are searching for inspiration as they dig for prehistoric fossils. And we'll introduce you to a college coach who used his home court advantage to take Oklahoma State all the way to the top. But first, many people know him as the Indian in the cupboard, but Gary Davis has come a long way since then. We caught up with him at his home here in Seattle, Washington, and again in Cherokee country, where all of his dreams began.
This is where my grandparents lived. Probably a lot of my most fond memories of growing up in Oklahoma were right there over on that patio. It's crazy because it doesn't look, you know, like a whole lot now, but when I was a kid, this was like kind of everything.
It's a little different going back today because everything has changed and you know, people have passed on, and to have my sons be back out here, sort of a kind of come full circle.
My name is Gary Davis, also known as Litefoot. So I started rapping in Oklahoma. I mean, people are like, well, Indians don't rap, you know, you can't do that. I've come out of the gate almost in that space with people saying you can't do that, you know, just in general in society. Indian people are this, and I rebel against that to the fullest. You know, long story short, it fuels my fire. I would, in Tulsa, be sitting there, and because I didn't have money to get instrumentals, I would turn on the classical station, and I would write stories and ideas to this music because it didn't have any vocals. That may be a very unique way to come up as a rapper, right? Again, it goes back to, hey, you know what? Where there's a will, there's a way. Till the fade black out, my war paint stay out. As a rap artist, I have 11 albums with another album coming. I have several different awards for that music, including Best Male Artist and Artist of the Year. I have toured throughout the United States and as far away as Rome, Italy. As an actor, my first role was Little Bear in the film The Indian in the Cupboard, directed by Frank Oz. One day, maybe I, you know, who knows. If I ever were able to do something that would get me to get an award, they go, oh, look, there goes the Indian in the cupboard getting an award. It's just one of those films that I don't think I'll ever not be that guy. And then I went on to do other films such as Mortal Kombat, Annihilation. I played Nightwolf. I played Hiawatha in The Song of Hiawatha. Most recently have added House of Cards to my filmography. I am an entrepreneur. I am an author, guy that just looks for something to do to be a little bit visionary. Definitely trying to move the envelope forward for Indian country. I actually started a record label called Red Vinyl Records. There is Davis Strategy Group, which will help other folks with marketing, branding, Litefoot Enterprises, which we both own and operate, and Native Style Clothing. I think that business and being entrepreneurs is probably one of the most traditional things that Native people have ever done. For me, being an entrepreneur is a very traditional activity.
Ladies and gentlemen, over the next few days, make it your focus right now to leave here with a bigger network than what you came here with.
So for the last 5 years, I have dedicated 120% of my time pretty much to the National Center for American Indian Enterprise Development as its president and CEO. I'm actually in the process of wrapping up my time. Just what we've been able to accomplish in the reservation economic summits and advancing millions of dollars worth of opportunity, and literally in some cases probably would amount to billions of dollars worth of opportunities for tribes and tribal enterprises. I think that is something that we have to do more of. We have to continue to find the ways as Indian country to work together. And it's been an honor to be in that position to help guide that and push it forward. When I get back to Oklahoma now, my sister still lives there, and I'll go out and see the family. I'll go visit my grandparents in Claremore at the cemetery. You know, as this new era of my life starts to come, you know, forward and unfold, that's one of the things that I think is probably one of the biggest blessings of all, is being able to spend time with your family and, you know, grow something with your family and do good, you know? I think that's really, what could be more exciting than that? You know, me being Cherokee, and representing that now across Indian country and around the world, it's been one of the things that is at the core of everything that I do. Has it been easy? No, absolutely not. But has it been worth it? Absolutely. Seeing my father, my grandfather, and everybody working together, I saw everybody contributing. Nobody questioned it. Nobody said, oh, it's too late or I'm too tired. They just got in and made it happen. I really think that was a big part of my growing up, is seeing people contribute to make something bigger than themselves happen and not let situations get you down. So absolutely, I stand on his shoulders. I stand on my father's shoulders.
And you're passing that on to your boys?
Yeah. I work so hard now to try to even do more than what they showed me so that they won't forget. Hopefully what they get out of it is that no matter what happens, no matter what you do in life, if you know who you are and you know your strengths and you keep pushing and you keep working and that you work harder than everybody else and that you really don't forget who you are, you're gonna come out on top.